the Lord, mightiest prophet of the Lord.
And then Senior Bishop Joanne. Well, now the Lord Jehovah Elohim, he has spoken with me. There is an earthquake that the Lord is sending now. He's going to use me to send an earthquake between Australia and Tasmania, I think Hobart, that kind of area. But these things were spoken about by the Lord Jesus, except that now we are of better understanding that these things are meant to be the landmarks and the hallmarks, to be the masterpieces, the demarcation on the prophetic timeline for the glorious coming of the Messiah. They mark the coming of the Lord. So I have seen the Lord coming, beloved people, and this is yet another opportunity for any person listening to make substantive gain in righteousness, in turning away from sin, in embracing repentance, and having repentant hearts, and walking in righteousness and holiness, and that the Holy Spirit will facilitate you. He is available to do that. That is the sole reason for which he was released from on high, to empower the church to overcome. This is he about whom it was written that I will send my messenger to prepare the way for you before your great and dreadful day. Beloved people, prepare for the coming of the Messiah. I have seen the Messiah coming. I have also seen the church that he takes. He's a holy church. She's very holy. Most recently in January, it took me up to 20 to 30 meters to the entrance to heaven above the sky here, and I saw a tremendous movement of a wonderful church that was entering into heaven, and the glorious steps they were stepping on as the big cloud, the huge, humongous cloud, opened the door to heaven, and they entered, and the joy that was throbbing in their hearts and beaming on their faces, and some of them got to look at me. And you know, for me, I get to see greater details, and sometimes I see individual people also. And yet I have not shared. So surely that day will come. That day will realize. Let us be prudent. Let our wisdom not fail us. Let us not focus on any other thing. But let us train our focus now on achieving the goal that without holiness, nobody will see the Lord. That we make progress and we develop on a daily basis from glory to glory to become more righteous. To become holier, to live a holier life, to become holy, that the Holy Spirit may then embed his mark, leave his footprint in our lives, that we may adhere to righteousness and holiness, and they may now become the hallmark of our lives and the signature of our identities, that we may shine light to this perishing world and harvest the souls. The Messiah is coming, beloved. Toda rabah lachem. Toda erev tov. Which is good evening in Hebrew. Shalom.